that fed the monasteries now work the weavers that drove a city of glass. Cotton first, then linen. Dozens of mills along the streams fitted out the people of the world. A small town emerging into a city of 1,000 streets. Fortunes won or lost in the price of cloth. Workers, hackers, mechanics, yawn haulers, band tires and carpenters. But it was the women who turned Belfast into Linenopolis. The thousands of doffers, spinners, reelers, winders and weavers, the heart and soul of the business. But inside, all were the same. The camaraderie of the put upon, the exploited. Only the mill owners and the men in white coats as enemies. The workers put all differences aside and trusted each other to do the right thing, to help each other out, and to sing songs that everybody knew. Steam pumps, shovels, and the house fittings of the workers in the grid of terrace streets. The city now clattered to the rattle of liberty, the roaring of glow lamps and furnaces, the clanging of engines, the glare of industrial fires, and the roaring echo of hard Belfast voices through the gates. Hammering men, booting sirens, phallic red chimney and belching. The River Farset witnessed great changes in the last 100 years. The industries that had made the city great rose and fell through 2 world wars and the Great Depression.